Hello there, Seth here from the Museum of Arts and Sciences, and I wanted to do a little demonstration on the different types of telescopes that are out there that you may want to purchase or you have at home. But before we get to that and how different telescopes work and different types, I wanted to mention that if you're ever into stargazing, the first way to get into this is actually using binoculars. These are actually astronomy binoculars. They're quite large. They have very large, what are called apertures here. But a lot of people just have even regular binoculars that are great for looking at the night sky, seeing very wide views of the stars. So I would recommend starting with binoculars first, and then step it up if you want to into getting your own telescope. And so we'll see here the different types that are available. This type of telescope is called a refractor. It's actually the earliest type of telescope that was invented more than 400 years ago. Galileo, the first to really use a telescope at the night sky, used this type of telescope. And it's actually quite simple. The original design just had two lenses. They have a little more today, but this is a more modern telescope, just a nice tube. And in the front, there is a lens called an objective lens, right in the front there. And light enters that lens, comes in, and the other lens would be the eyepiece at the very back of the telescope. So the light comes in through the objective lens, comes to a point, to a focus, and then you have the eyepiece at the back here, and you can change those out. And so this is the simplest type of telescope to get into. They're usually a little cheaper depending on the style and the size. You always want to go bigger if you can, but these are a good type of starter scope to get into, looking at the moon and the planets and even other deep sky objects as well. Refractors are a good way to start your exploration of the universe. This type of telescope is called a reflector and came a little after the invention of the refractor. This was invented by Isaac Newton, a really famous mathematician and physicist. And the idea is it uses mirrors. There is a tube, just like any other telescope that you have here, and these can come in different sizes, different arrangements. There's an opening on one side, and light would come in to one side, go through the tube, and at the bottom of it, if I turn it here, you can see there's a really big mirror. And it's a parabolic kind of rounded mirror. The light comes in, hits that mirror, the light then gets bent to a point all the way up to this secondary mirror that you see here. That little mirror pushes it out or reflects it back through this eyepiece holder here, and you look through that side of the telescope. Again, these come in different arrangements, different sizes, different setups, but that's all there is to it, just using mirrors, more mirrors instead of just lenses like a refractor. These can get a little bit bigger. They are a little heftier at times, but again, there are different types that are out there. If you look here, this is on a type of mount called a Dobsonian. So this is the kind of mount that sits very low, very easy to use, very quite simple. And if you want a bigger type of telescope, a Dobsonian reflector is the type to maybe go for. This type of telescope is called a cassegrain. And it's actually a type of reflector, so it does have mirrors, but it also has a lens as well. And this type of telescope actually is really big, but it's squished into kind of a smaller space for portability, but it still has a very wide aperture or opening in the front. So just like all the scopes we've been talking about so far, there's a tube here, all right, that holds all of the mirrors and different parts of the telescope. And if we turn it, you'll actually see the opening or the aperture here. And what happens is light comes through here, hits this actual piece of glass called a corrector plate, and that actually puts sort of an air into the light. And then the light hits this mirror in the back, that mirror is curved, and bounces the light back up again to this. There's a mirror behind this, another secondary mirror. That mirror then bounces it another time through the back one more, and there's a hole in the mirror at the very back. And that hole in the back is where the eyepiece goes. And so these type of telescopes, again, can be very large in aperture, but a lot skinnier, so you can move them around a little easier. And we use this type of telescope quite a bit for deep space type things, looking at nebulae and galaxies and various things like that. So this one's a bit more complicated, but still a very reliable type of telescope, a little newer type of design that we still see today. These are the three types of telescopes that you can typically find in the consumer telescope world. They're all different and have different uses depending on your needs, but hopefully you'll be able to find something that will work for your stargazing opportunities. If you want to know more about this, we actually put together this MOAS Guide to Telescope pamphlet. You can download it at the link provided, and it'll give you a nice overview of how telescopes work, how to set them up, some buying tips, and hopefully it will help you with your telescope needs. Good luck and happy stargazing.